Albatrosses carry the souls of dead mariners, according to an ancient myth anyway. That's why killing albatrosses brings bad luck.
We were motivated to start working on a technology that would hopefully resolve the horrific deaths of hundreds of thousands of seabirds, particularly albatross, on long lines.
Every year, hundreds of thousands of seabirds die from baited fishing hooks, including countless albatrosses, some of whose species are threatened with extinction. These two brothers from the UK have dedicated their professional lives to protecting seabirds and other marine life.
So the motivation for Ben and I to develop the hook pods was really to try and make a difference in terms of, you know, technologies that that could reduce bycatch, and not to get rich quick.
The edge of Dartmoor National Park in the southwest of England is home to engineer Ben Kibble. His great passion from childhood: science, technology, engineering, and problem solving.
I've always had a passion for technology and finding ways that technology can improve the environment rather than doing harm.
Ben's brother Pete has always had a special connection to the sea. The fate of the albatross is particularly close to both brothers' hearts.
Here's an example of a typical longline hook that's used for catching tuna and swordfish. So they would bait the hook, and then the hook would be cast into the water and clipped onto the main line, and you might have anything up to 50 kilometers of main line with 1,000 or 2,000 of these baited hooks on.
Albatrosses and other seabirds have learned that there is something to eat around the fishing boats. The fishermen let out hook after hook into the water from the boat, one every 5 to 8 seconds. The hooks are baited with squid or fish, and the bait attracts seabirds such as albatross. Right next to the boat, the baited hooks are still close to the water's surface. They can be reached by diving birds. As a result, thousands of those birds are hooked and perish every year. The Kibble brothers want to develop a device that only releases the hook when it's at a depth of around 20 meters, which is too deep for diving seabirds. This is a big technical challenge.
Fishermen are very conservative. They like to fish the way they traditionally have always fished. We knew the pod had to be very bomb-proof, very reliable and low cost, and also it couldn't interfere with the normal fishing operations.
At the brothers' own expense, they began to develop the so-called bait pod, a protective plastic cover intended to keep hook and bird apart. And this is what the concept looks like. Later, the brothers would apply for a patent.
This was our first version of pod, and we called it the bait pod, and it was far larger than the current version. And that's because we felt it was important that we encapsulated the hook and the bait. So one drawback with this bait pod is the size. It was so large that there wasn't room on the vessels, because they need between 1,000 and 2,000 of them on a typical vessel.
An additional problem: the straps that hold the pods together open unreliably.
The breakthrough moment in terms of development of the hook pod was when Ben came up with the idea of a pressure release mechanism that reliably opened the hook pod at a predetermined depth. That was a fantastic moment.
It was a feeling of total elation and relief that we'd got there, we'd got something that we knew would work.
The opening mechanism invented by Ben features a piston that is pushed against a spring by the rising water pressure. The resistance of the spring is calibrated so that it snaps open the hook pod when the pressure corresponds to the desired depth.
We try to make the hook pod as useful, affordable and practical to fishermen as possible. The hook pod also has a weight incorporated. See the weight here. and the weight's designed to increase the sink rate. When it's hauled after the fishing operation, it's clipped closed again, reset, and can be used, you know, for the next fishing set. And they can be used, you know, hundreds and hundreds of times, so they'll last for years.
The Kibble brothers have tested their hook pod for years in the waters of Brazil, South Africa, Australia, and other places. The result, the hook pod is a complete success. Compared to long lines without protection, it reduces bycatch of seabirds by 95%. At the same time, the hook pod, with its LED light, replaces chemical glow sticks. These are used to attract tuna, but contribute to the billions of tons of plastic waste in the oceans. For the Kibble brothers, it's now a matter of convincing the fishing associations and fleets of their invention.
So the New Zealand long line fleet is now pretty much completely kitted out with hook pods, and some of the big seafood suppliers, supermarkets, are also using hook pods.
In their joint company, Fishtech Marine, the inventors have already developed their next innovations, applications to protect sharks and to prevent dolphins or turtles from perishing in fishing nets. They hope that their invention from the small county of Devon will save as many creatures as possible from an agonizing death.